My name's Chloe, and I'll be taking you through this Intuiface Composer 101 course. In this first module, I will walk you through the different panels and menus available in the Composer. Keep in mind, all of these components, except for the menu bar, can be hidden if needed. We begin with a look at the menu bar, which enables you to open, save, and publish experiences, as well as modify various experience properties. It's a very straightforward kind of menu, the kind you'd expect from most software. Just below the menu bar is a set of circular buttons overlaid on a blue background. These buttons give you access to a series of panels that make up Intuiface Composer. Let's go through each of these. First, we have the Assets panel. With this panel, I can display all of the different types of assets used to build experiences. I can add an asset either by clicking on its icon or by dragging its icon onto the scene. There are four different kinds of assets, in which you can find classics like images, video, audio-based assets, but also unique options like the HTML frame that allows you to embed HTML code. You'll have a better understanding of these assets throughout the Academy. The Collection panel works pretty much the same way as the Assets panel. Like Assets, I can add any type of collection by clicking on the collection I want to use or by dragging it directly onto the scene. A collection is used to exhibit multiple items in a unified, interactive, and visually appealing context. A variety of collection styles exist, and they can be subdivided into three categories. Layout collections. These give you the freedom to place assets and other collections in any spatial organization you choose. The most basic collection is the group collection, which lets you group items together. This is particularly helpful when you want to aggregate assets into a logical or functional superset. Ordered collections. These assign an order to contained assets and collections, an order that is visually represented. One of the favorite ordered collections is the asset grid. It allows you to quickly scan through a collection of content in a horizontal or vertical sequence. This is super useful if you want to display a product catalog or paintings, for example. Dimensional collections. These collections let you organize content based on localization, like latitude or longitude, and time. For instance, the map collection enables you to display a fully interactive world map with customizable points of interest. Next to the collection button are design accelerators. These are pre-built assets, collections, and scenes available you can add to your experiences. For example, with design accelerators, I can insert a bunch of already designed navigation buttons into my scene. You can also create your own design accelerators if you want to reuse a visual element over and over again. I'm now going to open the content library. It's a list of all the graphic and auditory media that have been added into this experience. The content library makes it very convenient to update files already present in the experience, as well as to find content I'd like to reuse across multiple scenes. If I want to incorporate third-party data sources, business logic, or devices in my experience, I would use the Interface Assets panel. We have prepackaged quite a few interface assets, such as one enabling you to read and write from Excel, another using what we call API Explorer to automatically create integrations with third-party web APIs, and this one enabling you to access and display the current weather and weather forecast for any city. Now let's take a look at the Scene Structure panel. As you can see, this panel opens a view of the assets and collections present in the scene I'm actively editing. If I select an asset in the Scene Structure panel, for instance, it will highlight this asset in the scene itself. Selecting an item in the Scene Structure panel also enables me to view its properties in the Properties panel, which we'll look at in a moment. This is also where you would create and manage layers, a powerful feature enabling you to both control the visual stacking order of media, as well as easily share assets and collections across multiple scenes. As a designer, I would create and organize all of my scenes using the Scenes panel. This panel shows the scenes and scene groupings, called sequences, found in an experience. If I want to add a new scene, I just need to open the Scenes panel and use the Add Scene feature. Scenes can be easily reordered using drag and drop. Note that there is no right number of scenes, it's however many you think your project needs, and your audience will never know what scene they're on. The notion of scenes is something only you, the designer, need to be concerned about. Okay, let's now talk about the elephant in the room, this big area here beneath the blue ribbon. This is what we call the editing window, or the canvas. It's where you create a scene. Here, I directly add content to build my experience. I can easily change scenes by using the Scenes panel and test my experience with the very useful Play button. This Play button launches an embedded version of Intuiface Player, meaning you never have to install Player separately in order to test your work. I really recommend that all Intuiface users test their work as much as possible to ensure the consistency of the experience throughout its creation. The two final buttons we'll talk about open the Properties panel and the Triggers and Actions panel. The Properties panel shows the properties of the currently selected item in the Scene Structure panel or in the scene. I can modify some of these properties, like position, size, or orientation, by manipulating the associate asset or collection directly in the scene. Other properties can only be modified using the Properties panel directly. Note how the Properties panel often has vertically stacked tabs, each representing a different properties category, such as appearance, behavior, and tools. If I want to display all the properties available on an asset or a collection, I just need to select the asset or the collection, then display the Properties panel. For instance, I want to change the color of a rectangle asset. I just click on the Property panel after selecting the rectangle asset, then I will be able to adjust the color. The last button I want to talk about opens the Triggers and Actions panel. With this panel, I can add triggers and actions to pretty much anything inside my experience. Triggers are events that cause actions to occur. A trigger could be when a button is tapped, and an action could be then navigate to a new scene. There you have it. We reviewed all of the panels available in Composer. Feel free to organize your Composer view any way you want using these resizable and movable panels.